It's pretty crazy stuff. Khabib gave the UFC an ultimatum. Back off of my friend, put him back on the card, or cancel my contract too. Fire me too. Keep the money. He said, I hope you choke with my money. I hope it gets stuck in your throat. Pretty interesting stuff, given that Khabib just had the biggest win of his life. So this is some background. Khabib just beat Conor. He's on top of the world popularity-wise, notoriety-wise. He has everything on top of the world. And his friend, after the fight, jumped in the cage and hit Conor. And now Dana White fired his friend from fighting in the UFC. Anybody else, so pretty much 98% of the world, the 99% of the world would have told a friend, hey, I'll help you financially. You can work for me. I'll take care of you. But Khabib just wrote an open letter to the UFC on his Instagram, basically telling Dana White, hey, if you're not putting my friend back on the card, if you're not canceling the cancellation of his fight, then cancel my contract too. I'm okay. I'm walking away. I'm fine. I don't need your money. I don't need nothing. And we'll see who blinks first. We'll see if the UFC caves in, if they back down, if they find a way for Khabib's friend to fight on Khabib's next card. Because now Khabib basically has the UFC by the balls. He has them by the balls. Can they afford to lose their biggest superstar? I mean, Dana White is a stubborn dude, and he's a guy that it's his way or the highway. Many times he's put down the law and he's railroaded. Hey, you don't like it? Get out. You're fired. You're done. And now he's in a situation where his biggest superstar, not the biggest, Nate Diaz is the biggest, and Nick Diaz, don't get me wrong, but one of the biggest people the UFC is promoting heavily, that's more accurate, is threatening to quit and leave at his peak. Not after a loss, not after, you know, being out of the game for a couple years, but after the biggest win of his career. So I have to commend Khabib for standing up for his friend and being a loyal friend. Hopefully this sets an example for people what real friendship's about. Like, if you have a friend that's loyal to you, return the favor. Don't say, sorry, can't help you, you know? And Khabib in a statement said it's all about respect, not money, not fame, nothing. So we'll see where it goes from here. It'll be interesting to hear if Conor says, hey, put the guy back on the card. If Conor says, it's okay, let it slide. Very interesting stuff. What does it mean if Khabib leaves the UFC? Does that mean, does he start his own promotion company in Russia? Does he switch a sport? Does he go into boxing or another form of martial arts? And the other fighters follow suit? So let's see what happens. Let's see who climbs down the tree first. Who gets off the ladder first? Is it the UFC? Will they back down and say, okay, Khabib, you're right. We'll put your friend back on. Or will the UFC be stubborn and say, you know what, we don't need Khabib, we don't need this, no fighter makes the league, the UFC is bigger than any fighter. You want to leave, leave, we don't care. So it's going to be a very interesting stock, because the UFC invested a lot in promoting Khabib. Just imagine if they promoted Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz the way they're promoting McGregor and Khabib. Nate has 2 million followers pretty much on his own. Khabib has 11 million, but he's heavily promoted by the UFC, so is McGregor. I think McGregor has 35 million, if I'm not mistaken. I could be off. But there you have it. Stay tuned. But very interesting to see who's going to blink first in this standoff. My guess is that the UFC will contact Khabib and say, you know what, next time you fight, we're going to put your friend on the card. But right now we have to look like we're doing something so other fighters don't hit people when they're not supposed to. So they might tell Khabib, you know what, we'll give him a temporary suspension, but we'll let him fight soon. That's what I think will happen. But let's see. Stay tuned. FaizReport.com. I'm Malasek back reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter.